absolutely shocked Steve to find out that one of the platforms we're using to host the podcast has taken a decidedly daft turn. If this article from The Verge was anything to go by, with Vimeo effectively telling creators to suddenly pay thousands of dollars or leave the platform. That kind of headline kind of jumps out, especially when you're using the platform.
it's a weird one, but I guess it's sort of very modern, isn't it, where your only connection to the platform is via a bot and you never see a friendly face or have any personal relationship. It's a bit hard to get, you know, how you feel about these changes across to management.
The thing that sort of buzzes me out is it immediately sort of highlights that there aren't actually a lot of video hosting options. Prominent ones anyway. So you would think automatically YouTube is like number one, obviously. Vimeo was marketed as like the almost like the LinkedIn of video streaming services, where, you know, you, the professional filmmaker or whatever, would showcase their work on Vimeo because, you know, it was a cut above because, you know, the cat videos weren't on Vimeo, although I'm sure there's plenty of those on there too. So when something like this comes up, which kind of threatens one of those options, it kind of highlights how fragile some of this is, especially if, you know, going by what they were saying, that if, certain creators are having to, you know, pay thousands of dollars just because they were supposedly causing a bandwidth spike issue for Vimeo. That's not really that good at all.
No, it's not. And I think it also, you know, as you said, highlights how much things change in time. I mean, certainly our first experience with Vimeo was it hosted better quality video than YouTube, and, you know, it guaranteed us a better audience as well.
Yeah.
It's interesting though, because you know, in the article they specifically look at the cost of like hosting or streaming high quality video and the bandwidth that consumes and the cost that is to the Vimeo platform. It's a bit hard to actually work out what's going on, whether Vimeo's targeting what they feel are high value clients of the platform that should be paying more, and it's just a case of the price going up through the roof overnight when maybe that price should have been there for much longer, or whether, as the Vimeo CEO says, this is just a whole change in business model, and if you don't like it, see you later.
Lastly, before we move on, it could just be a boneheaded business decision that it doesn't have much foresight in terms of the consequences.